Hey guys, today we're going to talk about vent visors. Today we have a few tips to go for you guys, and you can see here I actually had vent visors on before. If you've seen this truck before, it had these on. These were from Wade, and I really like this design. It's a little bit bigger, and I wanted more of a sleek look, so I decided to go with AVS. These are much smaller. Also, on the Wade ones, they come all the way down. There are pros and cons when it comes down to the mirror. That particular design, it does obstruct the view of my mirror a little bit. The AVS one stops at the mirror. With our new ones in, you can see we don't obstruct the view for the mirror as much. Now you might notice that I put my convex mirror closer to the truck. Most people will put them on the outside. The reason being is I don't really tow with this truck. If I did tow, I would want my convex on the outside so I could see beyond the trailer. What I put the convex there for is just to immediately see my blind spot. So these smaller ones are a little bit better. They are transparent or translucent. You can still kind of see through them, but at night you might have a hard time seeing pedestrians crossing because they do obstruct your view a bit as opposed to not having them. That's why I like these smaller ones. I can see a lot more compared to my old ones. Now before we go on with the video, I want to mention I had some money left over my PayPal account, so I figured, okay, well, I'll just buy these AVS ones online. There is a pro and con to online. Online is very convenient. However, it came shipped, cracked over here, and now I have to go through the hassle of trying to get my money back. Then I end up getting at my local auto parts store. I end up spending about $15 more. That's okay. But at least if I have any issues, I can go straight to the store. So I myself, yes, I buy online. Yes, I work in a retail shop. And I think it's nicer when you can buy online from a retail shop. In case you have issues like this, you can just drive over to the retail shop. I think the two need to coexist. So that's just my little rant for today. I found this one a little bit interesting, and I'm going to say this is probably more relevant for older trucks. You might not have this problem if you're driving a brand new one. After I removed my vent visor over here, I actually was getting more road noise. I guess where the window meets inside this seal, it's not the greatest. So you can hear just a little bit of a whistle. If you have your stereo going, you're not going to hear it at all. But I did find that quite interesting after the removal. Installing the vent visors is pretty simple, but there is a little bit of prep work we have to do. So it comes with a Scotch-Brite pad, and that's what we're going to start with. And you're just going to focus on this outside one because that's where the adhesive is going to lay. You don't have to worry about this inside one over here. So we're just going to go lightly on there, and you're scuffing the surface just here on the passenger side. You see, getting a lot of that debris out there that's built up over the years. Next, we're going to clean the surface with the alcohol prep pad, and then you're going to use the surface prep pad. Going in here. See how much stuff comes out here. I'll just use the new side again. Quite a bit of stuff comes off of there. Make sure that's nice and clean. Now for surface prep, we only have one. Well, I have two because I have that other kit, but we only have one if you're only buying one kit. So make sure you do both sides evenly. And flip it over and go the other side. It is a colder day today, and because we're dealing with adhesives, I'm just going to use the low setting on my heat gun to help warm this up. You can use a hairdryer as well. To install it, you just leave most of the tape on so you can wedge it in and slowly work it in there and get it into place. The instructions don't say to pull off the mirrors. However, you have this support piece over here. And at first I thought that it was the same as this and it's supposed to go in between. Well, look how big it is. And in this part of the channel where the window goes in, it's not straight through. So looking at it, it's actually, they're off a bit. So this one is on further in and this one goes towards the outside of the truck. Now, I think what they want you to do is they want you to shove this in between the mirror. This is acrylic. It's still somewhat brittle. I don't want to just shove this in the mirror. So I found it a lot easier to remove the mirror, get it into place, and then we'll put the mirror back on top afterwards. I'm happy with its positioning, so we're just going to go ahead and remove the release film, work it in there, and we're going to roll the window up to help wedge it in. I'm also working my fingers on the inside and pushing down on the window molding to help it work its way itself in there. Take a little bit extra time to work the material into the window molding, so then you get a lot longer life out of it holding it in place. While you guys have parts off like this, I just hit it with a little bit of clear coat. What the clear coat will do is it'll help protect the metal, because how often do you ever take your mirrors off to clean them? You can see that there's dirt building up in here. So this can be a spot where rust can start and you'll have no idea until it's too late. Now, yes, keeping your vehicle clean at all times is the best way, and depending on the environment you live in, this may be okay or might get worse depending on the roads that you're driving and the conditions you're putting your vehicle through. So if you have stuff like this apart, clean it off, spray some clear coat, call it a day. See, putting on the mirror afterwards is a lot easier. And putting in our other mirror. I'm also putting a little bit of threadlock glue on the threads in the mirror so that way it doesn't want to get loose over time. Going over on gravel roads, there's a lot of vibration, and then these might start getting loose over time without you knowing, so putting a little bit of threadlock will prevent that. Obviously, you have to tighten it afterwards. Again, I'm going to hit it with light heat again, and I'm going to push down on this whole thing to help it stick more. Remember, this molding is really old, and we had another piece in here before that might have been a little bit wider. So helping heat it up and push it down with our hands, light heat, because you don't want this to get too hot and hurt yourself, will help it stick a little bit better. After you got the vent visor in place, you want to refrain from opening up the windows. They recommend that you give it at least 24 hours for the adhesive to cure. So leave the windows up. If you can be in a shop like mine, get it to room temperature, all the better. But if you can only do what you can do, so if it's going to be outside, just leave the windows up for 24 hours. Some of you might not like that logo on there and you want a cleaner look. So I'm using Goof Off here. It is water-based. And we're using it in our test piece here. I'm using a paper towel because it's a little bit abrasive, but not too much. You see, just take that logo right out, if you choose to. You don't have to take the logo out, but I like a cleaner look, and this is a test piece just so you guys can see it can be removed quite easily. If you want to be less aggressive, obviously you want to use a microfiber towel. All right, that's all done. It is looking good. I think the window looks so much better with this on there. It's just like that hint of an accent. I don't know, for whatever reason, I just love the way that vent visors look. It is subjective. But the main thing is the functionality. One thing I noticed when I had these out was, one, I was getting wind noise. Two, driving around in the morning, I was actually getting some glare. These actually do help with glare on the road. You can also get different versions. You can get the ones that go on the outside. In-channel one's my preferred one. There's different styles of in-channel that go bigger, like the one I had on the truck before. There's also ones that are even more thin than this. I believe WeatherTech makes one that's very straight and very close to the window if that's what you're after. I went with AVS. I've had their bug deflector on the front of this truck for 10 years. It served me well, so I know this stuff's pretty tough. Okay, let's do a water test for you guys. And does exactly what's supposed to. Crack the window open, no water gets inside. This one's broken and useless to me, and I typically don't do tests like this because I don't have spares, but I'm kind of wondering, how durable is this? Thank you. Okay, so I can't take a hammer dropping on it. But if you have a rock that big about to hit your vehicle, you got other problems. But, you know, light taps, it's marking up, it will get scratched. So if a small rock hits it, it's gonna scratch it. Remember, it is acrylic, so it is brittle. When you're installing it, don't really try to twist and turn it. Try to be as gentle as you can, keep it straight as possible. Let's see what it takes to break it. It's not indestructible, but fairly tough in my books. What do you guys think? Would you put a product like this on your vehicle? Now for me, I think this is a truck thing. I think trucks look great with these things on. And we can't dispute the functionality of them. However, I would never put it on one of my cars. Even though as functional as they are with glare and wind noise, I really don't like how they look on cars. It's just my opinion. What do you guys think? Would you put this on anything? Would you not want to have this at all? And if you do put these on, what style do you like? Comment below, I'd like to know.
If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way at all times you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section and it keeps applying it to different vehicles.